Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about the types of embryo sac. If we observe the angiospermic plant families, the angiosperm shows presence of three different types of embryo sacs, that is monosporic embryo sac, bisporic embryo sac and tetrasporic embryo sac. So, depending upon how many number of megaspores are participating in the development of embryo sac, depending upon that one, they are categorized under monosporic embryo sac, bisporic embryo sac, and tetrasporic embryo sac. So, let's see first what is the monosporic embryo sac. As we know that the female gametophyte, it is developed from a mass of cells called as an sporogenous tissue. So one of the cell, it get enlarges its size by accumulating nutrients from the surrounding cell. And it becomes functional. Now this functional megaspore undergoes first transverse division to form the dyad cell. This dyad cell undergoes one more time transverse division to form the tetrad. So see here what happened in monosporic type of embryo sac. So in this type, the three cells which are present at the micropylar end or the three cells which are present at the callosal end, they get degenerate and only a single cell which is present either at the micropylar end or at the callosal end, it becomes functional and undergoes further nuclear division to form the embryo sac. So this type, it is called as an monosporic embryo sac. So there are two types of embryo sacs which are observed under the monosporic embryo sacs, that is polygonum type and onanthora type. So let's see one by one the different types of embryo sacs which are present under the monosporic embryo sac. So let's see first how there is a development of a polygonum type of embryo sac. So let's see the development process. So see that the active megaspore undergoes first transverse division to form the dyad cell. This dyad cell undergoes further division or further transverse division to form the tetrad cell. In this polygonum type of embryo sac, here the three cells which are present at the callosal end, they get degenerate and the cell which is present at the micropylar end, it becomes functional and undergoes further nuclear division to form the embryo sac. So here, this one is the active megaspore. This active megaspore undergoes a nuclear division to form the binucleate stage. This binucleate stage again undergoes nuclear division to form the tetranucleate stage. This tetranucleate stage again undergoes one more time nuclear division to form the eight nucleate stage. And here, whenever there is completion of eight nucleate stage, there are no further nuclear divisions. The new divisions are stopped. And these eight nuclei, they are going to arrange the embryo sac. So see here, the four nuclei which are present at the micropylar end, from that, one nuclei comes in the center, while the four nuclei which are present at the callosal end, here also one nuclei comes in the center. And both these nuclei, they are going to form the secondary nucleus. While the three remaining nuclei which are present at the micropylar end, they functions as an egg apparatus, in which middle one functions as an egg, and these two lateral are synergids, while here the three remaining nuclei which are present at the chalazal end, they functions as an antipodal cell. So remember here, what is a polygonum type of embryo sac, in which there is the micropylar cell or micropylar megaspore, it is active one, and this polygonum type of embryo sac, it is the 8-nucleated embryo sac. So let's see the description of polygonum type of embryo sac, which we have already discussed in the figure. So see that this type of embryo sac, it is observed in the family Rosaceae, Rubiaceae, Ramnaceae, Asteraceae and Casuarinaceae. So let's see our next type of monosporic embryo sac, that is Onanthura type of embryo sac. So see here also the active megaspore undergoes first transverse division to form the dyad cell. These dyad cells undergo one more time transverse division to form the tetrad cells. So in this Onanthura type of embryo sac, the three cells which are present at the micropylar end, they get degenerate, and the cell which is present at the chalazal end, it becomes functional and undergoes nuclear division to form the embryo sac. So see here, these are the degenerating cells which are present at the micropylar end. This chalazal one, it remains active and undergoes nuclear division to form the binucleate stage. This binucleate stage again undergoes one more time nuclear division to form the 4-nucleate stage. But if you observe here, see that only these two nuclei, they are present at the chalazal end. There is no movement of this nuclei towards the micropylar end. That's why again the 4 nuclei, they are present only at the chalazal end. So after the formation of that 4-nucleate stage, the nuclear division gets stops, and these 4 nuclei, they are going to arrange the embryo sac. So the 3 nuclei which are present at the chalazal end, they move towards micropyle and functions as an egg apparatus, while the single one remaining, which is present at the chalazal end, it move towards center and functions as an secondary nucleus. So this type of embryo sac is observed in Onanthura. So see what is the difference here. In Onanthura type of embryo sac, here the three cells which are present at the micropyle, they get degenerate, and the embryo sac, it is formed from the chalazal nuclei, or you can say the chalazal megaspores. So let's see a description of Onanthura type of embryo sac. So see that the Onanthura type of embryo sac, it is observed in the family Onagraceae. That's why it has the name, that is Onanthura type of embryo sac. So next we see our second type of embryo sac, that is the bisporic embryo sac. So in this type, what happens, whenever the active megaspore undergoes first transverse division, it can form the dyad. But what happens in bisporic embryo sac, the actual cell plate is not formed in between that dyad. That's why 2 nuclei, they are present inside a single cell. And this binucleate stage undergoes further nuclear division to form the embryo sac. That's why it is called as an bisporic embryo sac. So basically, if we observe the bisporic embryo sac, they are 8-nucleated embryo sacs. And there are 2 types of bisporic embryo sacs, that is allium type and eudaimon type. So let's see one by one the development of allium and eudaimon type of embryo sac. So let's see this one. The megaspore active megaspore undergoes transverse division to form the dyad. Here, whenever there is further division, the cell which is present at the chalazal end, it get degenerate, and this binucleate stage undergoes further nuclear division to form the tetranucleate stage. This tetranucleate stage again undergoes one more time nuclear division to form the eight nucleate stage, and there is a development of normal type of embryo sac in which the three cells which are present at the micropyle, they functions as an egg apparatus. Three cells which are present at the chalazal end, they functions as an antipodal cell. And here the one nuclei from the micropyle and one nuclei from the chalaza, they move towards center and functions as an secondary nucleus. So let's take a look on description of allium type of embryo sac. So see that this allium type of embryo sac, it is observed in the genus Allium, as well as it is found in some of the families like Liliaceae, Amaryllidaceae, Orchidaceae and Alismaceae. So let's see the next type of bisporic embryo sac, that is Eudaimon type of embryo sac. So see that what is the difference in between Allium and Eudaimon type. Here the cells which are present at the micropylar end, they get degenerate, and this remaining two nucleate stage, means here actually the cell plate is not formed, that's why it is called as a binucleate stage. This binucleate stage undergoes nuclear division to form the tetranucleate stage. This tetranucleate stage again undergoes one more time nuclear division to form the eight nucleate stage. So after the formation of eight nucleate stage, there are no further nuclear divisions. These eight nuclei, they are going to arrange the embryo sac. So here these three cells, they functions as an egg apparatus. This three one, they functions as an antipodal cell at the chalazal end here, and one nuclei from the micropyle and one nuclei from the chalaza, they move towards center and functions as an secondary nucleus. So see this one, this is the description of embryo sac. So see that this Eudaimon type of embryo sac, it is firstly observed in Eudaimon hispanicans. That's why it has the name, that is Eudaimon type of embryo sac, as well as it is observed in the genus Polygonum, family Polygonaceae. So next we see our next type, that is the tetrasporic embryo sac. So in this tetrasporic embryo sac, there is involvement of four nuclei of four cells. That's why they are called as an tetrasporic embryo sac. And basically, this tetrasporic embryo sac, they are 16 nucleated embryo sacs. So see that these are the different types of embryo sacs which are observed under the tetrasporic embryo sac, that is Peperomia type, Penia type, Drusa type, Chrysanthemum type, Fritillaria type, Plumbagella type, Plumbago type and Adoxa type. So let's see one by one different types of tetrasporic embryo sacs. So let's see first the Peperomia type of embryo sac. So see here, in tetrasporic embryo sac, there are no cellular divisions. There are only the nuclear divisions. So what happens? The megaspore, active megaspore, it undergoes nuclear division to form the binucleate stage. This binucleate stage undergoes further nuclear division to form the tetranucleate stage. But see here, how these four nuclei are arranged. Here is one nuclei at the micropylar end, one at the chalazal end, and these two are at the lateral sides. So this four nucleate stage again undergoes one more time nuclear division to form the eight nucleate stage. This eight nucleate stage again undergoes further nuclear division to form the 16 nucleate stage, and that 16 nuclei, they are going to arrange, or they are going to form the embryo sac. So see here, out of that 16 nuclei, 8 nuclei move towards center and functions as a secondary nucleus, while 2 nuclei move towards micropylar end and functions as an egg apparatus, while remaining 6, they are arranged peripherally and they functions as an antipodal cells. So this type of embryo sac, it is described as Peperomia type of embryo sac, which is 16 nucleated. So let's see the description of this one. The next type of embryo sac, it is called as an Penia type of embryo sac. So see, what is the difference in between Peperomia and Penia type of embryo sac? There is a only difference in between the arrangement of 8 nuclei. If you observe the earlier one, so see that this is the Peperomia type of embryo sac, in which the two cells, they functions as an egg apparatus, remaining 6, they functions as an antipodal cell, and middle 8, they functions as an secondary nucleus. While if we observe the Penia type of embryo sac, so see here, this is the binucleate stage which undergoes nuclear division. Here the nuclei are arranged like the Peperomia type of embryo sac, then they are going to divide one more nuclear division to form the 8 nucleate stage. This 8 nucleate stage again undergoes nuclear division to form the 16 nucleate stage, and see that how these 16 nuclei are arranged to form the embryo sac. So here what happens, the 4 nuclei comes in the center and functions as an secondary nucleus, while 3 nuclei, they migrate towards the micropylar end, functions as an antipodal cell, while remaining 9 nuclei, they are arranged peripherally and functions as an antipodal cells. So this type of embryo sac, it is described as an Penia type of embryo sac. So see that this type, it is very much similar to the Peperomia type of embryo sac, and only there is difference in the arrangement of embryo sac. So this type of embryo sac, it is found in the family Malpighiaceae. So next we see our next type of embryo sac, that is the Drusa type of embryo sac. So see here is also the binucleate stage. It undergoes nuclear division to form the tetranucleate stage. But see here how these four nuclei are arranged. Here the three nuclei migrate towards micropylar end, and at the chalazal end there is presence of single nuclei. So further divisions takes place accordingly. Further nuclear divisions. So these three nuclei which are present at the micropylar end, they undergoes nuclear division to form the six nuclei which are present at the micropylar end, while the single nuclei which is present at the chalazal end, it undergoes nuclear division to form the two nuclei at the calazal end. So total here the embryo sac is 8 nucleate stage, but the difference is arrangement of the nuclei. So see here, again this 8 nucleate stage undergoes nuclear division to form the 16 nucleate stage. And after the formation of that 16 nuclei, there are no further nuclear divisions. This 16 nuclei, they are going to arrange the embryo sac. Here, the three nuclei, they migrate towards the micropylar end and functions as an egg apparatus. Two nuclei migrate towards the center and functions as a secondary nucleus, while all other remaining cells, this is the total 16 nucleate stage. Out of that, three move towards micropyle, functions as an egg apparatus. Middle two, they are functioning as an secondary nucleus, and all other remaining cells, they functions as an antipodal cells. So this is about the Drusa type of embryo sac. So see the description of that Drusa type of embryo sac. So this type of embryo sac, it is observed in the genus called as an Rubia, Ulmus and Mallotus. So next, see our next type of embryo sac under the tetrasporic embryo sac, that is the chrysanthemum type of embryo sac. So see here, what is the difference of that chrysanthemum type of embryo sac? So you see here, this binucleate stage undergoes nuclear division to form the four nucleate stage. But see here what happened. Here the one nuclei migrates towards the micropylar end, one nuclei towards the calazal end, and this middle two, they get fused with each other, and after fusion it becomes single one. Okay, so see here, here is one nuclei at the micropylar end, one at the calazal end, and there is fusion of these two nuclei, that's why it becomes single one. And this three nuclei again undergoes nuclear division to form the six nucleate stage. This six nucleate stage again undergoes one more time nuclear division to form either 9 or 12 nucleate stage, and that 12 nuclei, they are going to arrange or they are going to form the embryo sac. Out of that 12, three functions as an here the three one, they functions as an egg apparatus, then middle three, they functions as an secondary nucleus. Okay, and here the three which is present at the calazal end, they functions as an egg apparatus. So there are various types of difference in the chrysanthemum type of embryo sac, because in some of the species, if we observe the chrysanthemum type of embryo sac, they are either 6 or 9 or 12 nucleated embryo sacs which are observed under the chrysanthemum type of embryo sac. So let's see the description. So see that this type of embryo sacs, they show presence of either 6, 9, 10 or 12 nucleated embryo sacs. And here is 1 plus 2 plus 1 arrangement. Then the next type of embryo sac, it is called as an Fritillaria type of embryo sac. So here also, like the chrysanthemum, if you observe here, this binucleate stage undergoes nuclear division to form the tetranucleate stage. But what happens? Here there is a fusion of that three nuclei. There is fusion of that three nuclei, and after its fusion, it can form a single nucleus. So again, it is a binucleate stage, and this stage again undergoes nuclear division to form the four nucleate stage. Actually, this one is the triploid one. So these two cells or two nuclei which are present at the micropylar end or at the chalazal end, sorry, they are present at the chalazal end, they function or they are triploid one, and these two cells which are present at the micropylar end, they are haploid one. So it can undergoes one more time nuclear division to form the eight nucleate stage, and there is a development of normal type of embryo sac, but the difference is that here the antipodal cells which are present at the chalazal end, they are triploid one, and here the one secondary nucleus, it is also triploid one. Okay, so here after the formation of eight nuclei, three migrate towards the micropyle and functions as an egg apparatus, while three which are present at the chalazal end, they functions as an antipodal cells, and middle two, they functions as an secondary nucleus. But the difference is that here the one nucleus, it is triploid one, and the base cell or the three antipodal cells, they are also triploid one. So let's see the description of Fritillaria type of embryo sac. So see that this type of embryo sac, it is observed in the genus Lilium, Piper and Tamarix. Then our next type of embryo sac, it is called as an Plumbagella type of embryo sac. So see here what happens. This is the binucleate stage. This binucleate stage undergoes nuclear division to form the tetranucleate stage. But here also there is a fusion of that three nuclei, and it can forms only a single nuclei. That's why again it becomes binucleate stage, in which one is triploid one and one is haploid one. Means the haploid, it is present at the micropylar end, and the triploid nuclei, it is present at the chalazal end. So it can, this binucleate stage, after its after the fusion of that three nuclei, it undergoes one more time nuclear division to form the four nucleate stage, and these four nuclei, they are going to arrange, or they are going to form the embryo sac, in which one migrate towards the micropyle, which is haploid one, and functions as an egg, while the middle two, they functions as an secondary nucleus, and the cell which is the basal single cell which acts as an antipodal cell, it is only a triploid cell. So this is the description of Plumbagella type of embryo sac, which is four nucleated embryo sac. So see that here the three nuclei which are present at the chalazal end, they fuses to form a one. That's why it again becomes the binucleate stage. So see that they are going to fuse and to form the binucleate stage. Again, they are going to form further nuclear. Again, it undergoes further nuclear division to form the tetranucleate stage, and these four nuclei, they are going to arrange the embryo sac. So let's see our next type of embryo sac, that is the Plumbago type of embryo sac. So see here, this is the binucleate stage which undergoes nuclear division to form the four nucleate stage. This four nucleate stage again under, but if you observe that four nuclei, they are present peripherally. So they undergoes further nuclear division to form the eight nucleate stage. Sometimes the Plumbago type of embryo sac, after the formation of eight nuclei, it again undergoes further nuclear division to form the 16 nucleate stage. or after the formation of 8 nucleate stage, the divisions are stopped. So see that how the embryo sac is going to form. Here the one nuclei, it migrates towards the micropyle and functions as an egg apparatus. One, it moves towards calyce and functions as an egg apparatus. These are the middle four, they functions as an secondary nucleus. And those antipodal cells which are remaining one, they are going to arrange peripherally or they are going to arrange laterally, and further they are going to degenerate. So this type of embryo sac, it is called as an plumbago type of embryo sac. So this plumbago type of embryo sac, either it is 8 nucleated, 10 nucleated or 16 nucleated. So see that this type, it is firstly reported in Plumbago capensis. That's why this type of embryo sac has the name, that is Plumbago type of embryo sac. So let's see our next type of tetrasporic embryo sac, that is the Adoxa type of embryo sac. So see here, this binucleate stage undergoes nuclear division to form the tetranucleate stage. At this tetranucleate stage, two nuclei, they are present at the micropylar end, and two nuclei, they are present at the calyceal end. This four nucleate stage undergoes further nuclear division to form the eight nucleate stage, and one of the nuclei, it undergoes one more time to form the 10 nucleate stage. So here what happens? Here the four nuclei which are present at the micropylar end, they functions as an egg apparatus. Four nuclei which are present at the calyceal end, they functions as an antipodal cell. While the nuclei which is present at the micropylar end, it one more time divide, it undergoes one more time of nuclear division to form the two nuclei, and these two nuclei, they are going to arrange in the center and functions as an secondary nucleus. So this type of embryo sac, it is described as an Adoxa type, in which four nuclei, they functions as an egg apparatus. Four which are present at the calyce, they functions as an antipodal cells, and two which are in the middle functions as an secondary nucleus. So let's see description of Adoxa type of embryo sac. So see that this type of embryo sac, it is firstly observed in the Adoxa moschatiella. That's why it has the name, that is the Adoxa type of embryo sac. So just take a look on the types of embryo sac and how many nuclei they are present in that type of embryo sac. So see that in Polygonum, there is presence of 8 nucleated embryo sac. On Anthora, it is 4 nucleated embryo sac. Allium, this Polygonum and On Anthora, these are the types of monosporic embryo sac. While this Allium and Idemion type, these are the types of bisporic embryo sacs, which are the 8 nucleated embryo sacs. Then all other remaining types, these are the types of tetrasporic embryo sac, in which Peperomia, it is the 16 nucleated embryo sac. Penia, it is 16 nucleated embryo sac. Drusa, it is also 16 nucleated embryo sac. There is variation in the chrysanthemum type of embryo sac, in which we are going to observe either 6 nucleate, 8 nucleate, 9, 10 or 12 nucleated embryo sacs. While the Fritillaria type of embryo sac, it is 4, again 8 nucleate stage. और 8 न्यूक्लिएटेड एम्ब्रियो सैक, देन प्लुम्बाजेला इट इज 4 न्यूक्लिएटेड एम्ब्रियो सैक, देन द प्लुम्बैंगो इट इज 8 न्यूक्लिएटेड, देन दिस एडोक्सा टाइप इट इज आइदर 8 और 10 न्यूक्लिएटेड एम्ब्रियो सैक. So this is about the types of embryo sacs which are observed under the angiosperms, that is monosporic, bisporic and tetrasporic. Thank you. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.